Hi, I'm Lee Teschler with EE World and Design World. I'm here with Alex Lidow from EPC, who makes gallium nitride transistors and gallium nitride circuitry. Right next to us here is a wirelessly charging drone demo. Alex, tell us a little bit about what we're looking at here.
Well, first of all, we all hate power cords, but things in the air hate power cords worse than anything else. So one of the challenges is to make objects that can fly electrically and don't have to land in order to be recharged for long periods of time. So Solus Power, our customer here, developed a system where they can actually charge these drones several inches above a charging pad on moving automobiles. So these cars can run around and have these drones overhead. Eventually they want to power the tops of buildings and power poles so they can do package delivery like that. But wireless charging and wireless power is just beginning to impact our lives. Pretty soon we'll be able to get rid of our power cords and reduce the batteries that we have to use for our laptops and cell phones.
What's the advantage of using gallium nitride in a wireless charging circuit?
Well, this system for the drone is at 13.56 megahertz, which is a pretty high frequency for silicon. So it's nowhere near as efficient as it is with gallium nitride. And the same is true for all of the wireless charging that you see for laptops and notebooks and cell phones. Just more efficient with GaN and lower cost.
I see. Is it the GaN that lets them go to that higher frequency?
The GaN is not only lets them go to higher frequency, but lets them use their wireless charging over a wider range of products without having to redesign the antenna for it.
Hmm. Well, we've actually got their little circuit board here. Can you point out the EPC technology on it?
You got to have a powerful magnifying glass for that because it's right there. It's a little shiny blue FET, a couple of them right there. You can barely see it. That's why we hand out magnifying glasses to our customers.
Well, that's a lot of technology in a small package.
Well, gallium nitride tends to be 5 to 10 times smaller than silicon for the same power handling. So get used to the small sizes.
Could they even do this with silicon?
Well, I think that they could do it, but it would be it would lose a lot of power, and it would be a lot bigger and more expensive.
Gotcha. Well, that's interesting, Alex. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Lee.
All right.